trucks have, man. Like, what the hell do they rescue out here?
These two dogs were actually found dumped along the side of a very rural road in Texas.
This is a very nice animal shelter.
We were informed that one of the dogs microchipped back to us. That's when it became a whole different kind of rescue.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Welcome.
How are y'all?
Good.
So
who's the one that found the dogs?
Dino.
This is Dino.
Yeah. I was on another call at the time, and my friend was blowing up my phone. So I called him back, and he said, hey, my dad saw two dogs in cages on the side of the road. And he told me about where they were, so I went to that location. Sure enough, I found them.
Wow.
Like what road? Like in the middle of nowhere kind of
thing? It's a little country road, just off of a main road.
Mm-hmm.
They were about a quarter of a mile from the main road.
Wow.
The condition they were in were very emaciated. Very, very skinny. They were a little standoffish at first, but they came around, became very friendly. But I could tell that they've been through a rough time.
I mean, of course, the million-dollar question is like, why didn't you just bring them to the shelter?
I know.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know.
So why?
Yeah. Maybe they were worried about bringing them to the shelter because they were so skinny.
Yeah.
A lot of people, maybe. If they're that malnourished, they're worried they're going to get in trouble.
Yeah. It's hard getting that visual out of your head, you know, like seeing the pictures of them. Just, I mean, you think, ugh, I want to get emotional. What were they thinking when the person dropped them off and drove off and just left them there? Like, what were they thinking? Like, how long were they out there? How many cars passed by and didn't even stop? But, you know, they're safe. That's all that matters. You know, even though the other dog's not ours, we're not going to leave her behind. I mean, you know.
Yes, we appreciate that. They do love each other, yes.
When I pick them up, I put... is it Nina?
Right.
So I put her in the truck first, and then the little one just went ballistic.
Oh.
I wanted to be with her. So, yeah, as soon as I loaded her up, she calmed down.
Oh, wow. Are they together in the kennel?
No, they're separate, but okay. We walk them several times a day, so they walk them together. And
okay, well, I guess we'll go take a look at them.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Let's do it.
The Kendall County Animal Shelter turned out to be an amazing place. A ton of empty kennels. The dogs were not in any danger of being euthanized. But I would never want to burden a public animal shelter with two pit bulls when one of them belongs to us. You know, I'm like, we'll take them. They're ours.
Oh, hi. I'm gonna take my mask down. Hi, Nina, you don't remember your name is Mama. You're going to. Yes, Mama, you're going to. You're gonna go too.
Yeah, they are sweet.
Yeah. Nini.
Hi, I know.
Nini. Oh,
Nini. When I saw the two dogs, they were pretty underweight, but then I expected it. You know, I'd seen the pictures already.
We went ahead and heartworm tested them. They're heartworm negative. The kennel techs gave them baths yesterday and trimmed their nails.
They cleaned them up and they gave them like a little spa day. I mean, they looked good otherwise, except for their weight.
Y'all gave them their shots.
The only thing we
dewormer.
Didn't do was
because they have worms.
They have worms.
Okay. Reunited.
Yes.
We're reunited.
Yeah, she's a talker.
Yeah. Reunited.
She likes to let you know.
Yeah.
It's definitely really crazy to find one of our dogs like over a decade later, and in a whole nother state. I mean, we adopted the dog out in California, and she somehow made her way to Texas.
Oh my goodness. You're gonna have the whole place to yourself.
She's totally deaf.
Oh, I was gonna say, because she's like, oh.
This is very nice.
Huh?
This is very nice.
I know, I love this. I know.
Yeah. We've got a couple more on the other end if y'all wanna see them, but.
Sure, you can walk us around, yeah. We'll be back.
Yes.
So you have a good adoption rate?
We do.
To have
very
such a,
good, yes.
God, that's
we've had 10 adoptions the week before Christmas.
Wow.
All 8 were adopted out within a week.
Wow.
The people that worked there were so nice and so welcoming. They made us feel very comfortable. And the animal shelter itself was a really nice place. It was super clean. All the dogs were, you know, not barking and like, you know, going crazy at us. So it was a really nice place.
We've been trying to pull from San Antonio shelter.
Oh yeah, the bigger shelters.
Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
Don't be scared, little cat dog. Don't be scared. You're cute. You're cute. Look at the little one's like, what?
Yeah, that's Grayson.
What up?
He's a little old man.
Oh.
So we don't have very many right now because we
No, that's great.
Yeah, that's so amazing. It's really fast, so.
They had just had a really good adoption run. The people there were so welcoming. You know, it was a really, really nice place.
Here comes Tank.
Oh my God, he's so pretty.
That's a really pretty dog.
Hey. Oh my God, he's so pretty. Yeah. Oh,
you are so pretty.
Isn't he so pretty?
Why didn't anybody take you for Christmas?
Yeah, he is so pretty.
You look like a Christmas dog. Oh my God. So pretty.
Oh no, it's okay.
My houndies are always slamming me into the walls. Oh my God, you're so
pretty. Gosh, he's so pretty.
You're a good boy.
Dude, you are so cute. Yeah. Oh my God. You are adorable.
God, how did no one take him?
I don't know.
We'll take your jail picture. Got your tongue sticking out. Okay. Alrighty.
Okay.
Let's go get our poochies.
Yeah. Hi, Nini. There she is.
Hi, Nini. Oh my
goodness. You're okay. I know you want to go.
The second dog, the white dog with the tan patches, was not a Villalobos dog, but there was no way we were gonna leave her behind.
No, she loves her, and they love each other, but she's a little...
spicy. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on. Let me put her little ball down here.
I'll lead the way, Okay. Bye, guys.
Come on. The fact that these dogs were abandoned on the side of the road and are now going to a awesome home, the best ever, back home where they belong, is just amazing. We like to get the message out there that microchipping works. And if you microchip, a lot of times people will try their hardest to get the dogs home. And in this case, it worked. So we're very, very excited that they're going home.
Come on, Nini. Come on.
Load up, baby.
Oh, she goes, do I have to go to one of these again? This one's not going to end up on the side of the road. I promise. Come here.
Come on, little one.
Come on. Oh,
see?
No.
It's okay. There you go.
It's a little tight. I know, it's a little tight.
All right. Hi, girls.
You guys are okay?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Nice meeting y'all.
Nice meeting you.
Our motto is once a Villalobos dog, always a Villalobos dog. And I mean, she's still one of us. So now we get them vetted, get them taken care of, and try to find them a home.
You're a little worrywart.
She's, man, so much has happened.